welcome to Conservation Connect, where we connect you and your classroom to awesome animals, exciting careers, and new technologies. Today, we're going to take an electronic field trip all the way down to Florida to Crystal River National Wildlife Refuge, a place that was created for the protection of the endangered West Indian manatee. This unique refuge preserves the last unspoiled and undeveloped habitat in Kings Bay, which forms the headwaters of the Crystal River. The refuge preserves the warm water spring sanctuary, which provides important habitat for the manatee populations that migrate here every single winter. Now, in the winter, Kings Bay's warm water springs host the largest natural population of manatees in the entire state of Florida. Manatees, which are sometimes called sea cows, are very gentle creatures who are herbivores, which means they only eat plants and vegetation. Now, just like whales and dolphins, these water creatures are mammals, which means they have to come up to the water surface to get air. They only have to come up to the water surface about every 20 minutes. Now, how long do you guys think you could hold your breaths for? Probably not more than a minute. You see, when sailors were at sea for a long, long period of time, they actually believed they saw mermaids, which some people now believe were probably manatees. Crystal River National Wildlife Refuge has installed an above-water webcam in order to allow visitors and people from all around the world that otherwise would never be able to see a manatee up close and personal to be able to observe the manatees in their natural habitat and allow them to feel like they are right there. The camera allows the public to become educated about why it's so important that these species be protected. They are gentle animals, and it only becomes more evident when you can see them and spend time with them either physically or virtually. Today, I'm here with Ivan Vicente, and he's come all the way up from Florida at Crystal River National Wildlife Refuge to be with us here today at the National Conservation Training Center right on the Potomac River. Ivan, thank you so much for being here today.
My pleasure to be here this morning.
And I hear you are a visitor service specialist and environmental educator. Can you tell me a little bit about what you do there?
Well, we mainly want to educate people about what manatees are doing and how to protect them, how to actually live and coexist with them. So there's a lot that goes along with that, mainly from environmental education to children and then also adults that come to visit this incredible place to swim with the manatees. So before people swim with manatees, we want to make sure that people understand the rules and behave responsibly.
Sure, sure. Now you get to work with these manatees all the time. How big are these guys?
Well, 13 foot long, and to just give you perspective on how big that is, if you look at a basketball hoop, it'll be 3 feet even taller than a basketball hoop from the floor, so pretty big.
Wow. And now these manatees are an endangered species. Why is it that they're endangered? What's going on?
Well, unfortunately, manatees actually live in the same place where boaters roam, the same traffic areas where a lot of boaters are speeding, and a lot of manatees then unfortunately get hit by boats. But that is not the main reason. The main reason is actually cold stress. Manatees need thermal areas to survive the winters. They're in Florida, it gets pretty cold in Florida, so it's not the sunshine state all year round. manatees must seek a spring area, and sometimes they don't get there in time to where the springs are. And where I work is where the springs are. That's where they winter, where they spend the winter. So a lot of them, they suffer hypothermia, and they get too cold, and they unfortunately, some of them die.
Oh, it's too bad. How many are left right now?
Well, great numbers, over 4,000 manatees. And 20 years ago, we had just above 2,000, so the population has doubled in 20 years.
Wow, that's great to hear. So you're working with these manatees. What are you doing in your job to help protect these manatees?
Well, we do manatee rescues. I do a lot of education. I put together materials for children and also for adults to learn about them. And I'm currently actually working on these four videos so that people understand what to do before they enter the water to see the species, to observe these species in the water. And those four videos is one for swimmers so that swimmers know how to behave when they're swimming. Another one for boaters so that boaters can boat responsibly and not hit a manatee. The other one is for paddlers. Paddling, such as kayaks, paddleboards, and canoes, can disturb manatees quite easily. So we teach them how to paddle properly and what to look for, what signs of manatees. And the fourth one is for photographers and videographers, so that those photographers and videographers don't get too close and disturb them when they're resting and sleeping or feeding. So.
Okay. And then I had another question for you, and that is, you guys have installed a webcam above the water. Tell me about that webcam and how that's helping educate the public.
Well, the webcam is a fantastic tool, not just for us, but also for visitors. We place it right above where manatees rest, and sometimes we have over 200 in this one little confined area. And the webcam films constantly, 24/7, 24 hours, 7 days a week. And then also the general public can get on this webcam and view manatees remotely from home to see what manatees actually are doing on their day-to-day basis. So it's a fun tool for families across the nation to see and enjoy what manatees do.
Ivan, thank you so much for being with us today. To learn more about these amazing creatures and to be able to watch them live right from your own computers, just again, visit that website on the screen from Crystal River National Wildlife Refuge. There's so many more amazing facts and ways that you guys can even help. So go be scientists and enjoy observing these magnificent creatures. We'll see you next time on the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service's Conservation Connect.